Dear students, welcome back to Business Law and Ethics class of BBA, second year, fourth semester. We are in the third unit, that is regarding Companies Act. See, till now, in this chapter, we have learnt about definition of company, the derivation of the word company, from where the word has been derived, we came to know about it, characteristic features of company, classification of companies, how many types of companies are there, that we have discussed, formation of a company or incorporation of a company, we have discussed, memorandum of association and articles of association. Up to here we have discussed. See, in the previous classes we came to know that memorandum of association is a very, very important document, in fact the most important document in a company's history. It is constitution of a company. It describes company's relationship with outsiders, whereas articles of association is related to company's internal affairs. This is the second important document. The most important one is memorandum of association. It is also known, in short form you can call it as MOA, memorandum of association. This one you can call as AOA. Okay. So in the subject, next topic is prospectus. But before going to prospectus, let us try to find out the differences between memorandum of association and articles of association. See, these are the differences between memorandum of association and articles of association. See, as mentioned, this is the charter of the company. Means very, very important. Charter means very, very important draft, which describes its liabilities, its rights, its duties, its functions, its objectives. Everything will be described in a charter. So in memorandum of association is the most important document. It is just like for a country, constitution is important. For a company, MOA is important. Coming to articles of association, it just describes the regulations for internal management. Okay. Well, everybody's powers, everybody's qualifications, everybody's rights, everybody's duties, everybody's responsibilities will be described so that company can be regulated. Management can look after the company in a better way. Without rules and regulations, it is hard to ensure discipline in the organization. So articles of association, AOA, ensures rules and regulations are there and for the betterment of the company, for the objective or goal reaching of the company, they are very, very important. Okay, so it is referred to internal management only, whereas it is charter of a company. Okay, it defines the scope of the activities. I mentioned, see how many clauses are there? I mentioned in the previous classes. Memorandum of association, whatever the items that are there, they are very good. They are classified into clauses. There are six clauses in memorandum of association. What are they? What are the clauses in memorandum of association?
Name clause, registered office clause, object clause, liability clause, capital clause, subscription clause.
Very good. The most important clause is which one? Object clause. Object clause is the most important one. So based on object only, scope of a company will be determined. So that is why beyond objectives, whatever that is mentioned in the objectives, a company cannot carry out its operations. If a company carries out its activities beyond objectives, then those activities will be invalid. Okay, the persons responsible will face civil and criminal proceedings. Okay, so that is why it defines the scope of the activities. Whereas coming to articles of association, it lays down rules for carrying out the objectives of the company. See, objects will be mentioned in a memorandum of association. What are the rules in order to achieve those objectives will be mentioned in articles of association. It is, as I mentioned, it is supreme document. It is chart means supreme, charter, supreme document. No other document is above memorandum of association. Whereas it is subordinate to the memorandum. The supreme is, means no, nobody, no other document is a head of the memorandum of association. Whereas subordinate means it should be in accordance with memorandum of association. Whatever that is mentioned in memorandum of association, it should not cross it. Articles of association is only a subordinate to the memorandum. See, in college you take principal sir is the supreme sir. And we are all subordinates to him. Whatever he says, we have to do. Whatever we say, he may accept or may not accept. Whatever we give, we just give suggestions. But he is supreme, we are subordinates. Similarly, in memorandum of association, certain things will be mentioned. In articles of association, certain things will be mentioned. Certain issues will be mentioned. Whatever that are mentioned in the memorandum of association, they are supreme. Whatever that are mentioned in articles of association, they are only subordinate to the memorandum of association. So article memorandum of association is must for every company. Every company should have its own memorandum of association. They cannot copy from others. See, I mentioned the clauses of memorandum of association. They have been divided into 6 types. Name clause, registered office clause, objects clause, like that. Subscription clause, likewise I mentioned. See, every company has its own name. It cannot copy others company's name. Every company has its own registered office. It cannot be copied. See, in examination, if 2 students are copying, let us take for example, 1 student is copying from another student. He can copy the entire answers, but hall ticket number, he cannot copy. If he copies means, to both the papers will be very, very strictly scrutinized. Similarly, in case of memorandum of association also, name clause, it cannot copy. Name, it should have its own name. It should have its own registered office. So that is why it is must for every company. Every company should have its own memorandum of association. But in case of articles of association, in types of companies I mentioned, limited company, unlimited company, limited by liability, 3 types I mentioned under one heading, you can verify. See, a company limited by shares need not have its own articles of association. If they prepare, that is well and good. Even if they did not prepare, they can follow a model articles of association is there in table A in a Companies Act, that is under the heading table A. So they can follow those model articles of association. Those are very good rules and regulations prescribed. If a company limited by shares does not prepare its own articles of association, it can follow the rules and regulations mentioned in table A of a Companies Act. Okay. As I mentioned in the earlier classes also, I mentioned it is very, very difficult. It is not impossible, but it is very, very difficult to make any alterations, means any changes. If you want, you can change, but they require permission from a tribunal, means a court or a central government. In some cases, in some clauses, you have to approach central government. In some clauses, you have to approach a tribunal, means special court. Okay, so strict restrictions will be there. Alterations only with the permission of a court or the special court, that is tribunal or central government. So, whereas in case of articles of association, they can be altered by special resolution. Okay, in a company's meeting itself, by passing a special resolution, articles of association can be changed. Okay, so in memorandum of association, as mentioned in the previous classes, it defines the relationship between company and outsiders. How a company should behave with outsiders, everything will be mentioned in memorandum of association. With the help of memorandum of association, companies' outside boundaries will be defined. Whereas it is related, articles of association is related to within company, means the company and its staff and the members and their interests, everything will be discussed deeply in articles of association. So it is with reference to inner component, whereas it is with reference, memorandum of association is with reference to outer component, outside the company, how to establish a relations. If they read memorandum of association, it will be okay. So I hope you understood the differences between memorandum of association and articles of association. Yes, is there any doubt or did you understand? Did you understand? Okay, Aditya, yes. Now coming to next topic I mentioned, prospectus. What is a prospectus? See, in world, several companies are there. Every year, new companies will be formed. Some companies request money from the public. They collect money from the prospective shareholders. Whoever wants to invest in a company, if they are interested, the companies will seek money from the shareholder, from the prospective shareholders. So, see, in case, before we discuss about prospectus of a company, in college, some colleges also print prospectus. Means prospectus is a document which says something about the organization to the public. See, suppose a college issues a prospectus, prepares a prospectus. In the prospectus, everything regarding where the college is situated, what is the name of the college, how many courses are there, how many groups are there, what is the medium offered, whether it is for males or females, or it is a co-education college, what are the benefits, advantages if you join in that particular college, whether campus placements are there or not, how everything will be, what are the various resources that are available, means library or technological resources like computers, laptops, or any other things will be mentioned in that prospectus. So similarly, in case of company also, prospectus implies it is a document which introduces itself to the public and seeks money from the public. I mentioned in company form of organization, even persons from across the world can invest their money in a company form of organization. So outside world, how they know about your company? We have to mention everything regarding you, your company. What are you going to do? What are your objectives? When it is going to be established? What is the investment? With this investment, what the company will do? Everything needs to be mentioned in a prospectus. So in simple terms, prospectus is a document which introduces a company to the public, seeking money from the public, requesting money from the public. That is what you mean by saying prospectus. Okay, so every year several new companies try to enter into market, float public issues means they request money from public by way of debentures, by way of shares like that. Okay, so all companies are not genuine. Genuine means they are not serious. They are not true. Some may want to exploit the investors. Some companies may want to cheat the investors. See, in our cell phones also, in our mobile phones also, daily we will receive so many messages. 99% messages are not genuine. You press this. If we are vaccinated, you press this, press one, they will say. If you press one means automatically your entire bank balance will become zero. So some want to exploit your weakness. Similarly, some companies want to exploit the weakness of investors. So the investors require total information regarding a company before investing in that company. So that is why prospectus introduces company to the public. What type of company it is? Why it is seeking money from the public? Whether the company is newly established or for its expansion process, they are requesting money. Everything needs to be mentioned in a prospectus. So in our country, in order to protect the interests of investors, SEBI is established in 1992. We have to remember this. SEBI. In 1992, it is established. SEBI means Securities and Exchange Board of India. See, securities means stocks, shares, bonds, everything will be termed as securities. Okay, so in order to protect the interests of the investors in our country, SEBI is established, Securities and Exchange Board of India. Its establishment year, full form of SEBI is important. I will ask in subsequent classes. In competitive examinations also, it is important. So as per the guidelines, as per the rules and regulations of SEBI, a company should disclose everything about it to the public in the form of prospectus. Okay. The, as I mentioned, in this disclosure includes information like reasons for raising money, what purpose the company is collecting money. They have to inform in prospectus. Okay. After collecting the money, in which way the company proposes to spend it. Okay. If they invest, what is the expected return? Suppose I have invested 100 rupees in the company. What is the expected return? Every year, how many rupees I may get? If the company is newly established, the company may not have any idea. But an existing company, for its expansion process, they are demanding money. They are requesting money. So in the previous years, how much dividend they paid to shareholders? How much returns the company has yielded? In the previous years, what are the profits and losses the company has enjoyed or incurred? That has to be mentioned. Okay. So every information regarding investors' interest will be mentioned in prospectus. Okay. That is why prospectus should be prepared neatly, attractively. Okay. Preparation of a prospectus in a beautiful manner to attract prospective investors is very, very important. Okay. So prospectus includes information regarding the size of issue. Means size of issue means how many rupees they are going to collect from investors. The current status of company. What is the current position of the company? Its equity cap, how much capital it has now. Its current and past performance. I mentioned, no? It is new company means it is not possible. But it is old company means the company will have its history. That has to be forwarded in prospectus. Okay. The promoters. Who are promoters? Promoters. Ken. Who are the promoters? Yes.
Owner of the company.
Not owner of the company. Owner of the company is a shareholder. Shareholders are owners of the company. Promoter is a person who establishes a company by taking all the risk. Promotion of a company, in the previous classes I mentioned, he takes all the risk. They take all the risk. Means they pull up material, they pull up men, they pull up other resources so that the company is established. Okay. So who are the promoters? The project, what project they are taking up? Cost of the project, how much investment is required? Apart from this, what are the other sources of financing? From which financial resources they are collecting money? What is the product that they are going to produce? What is the capacity of the organization? Everything needs to be mentioned in prospectus. Okay. Not only this, some mandatory means compulsory information as per SEBI. SEBI has issued guidelines in issuing of prospectus. So compulsory information regarding underwriting and statutory compliances. See, what is underwriting? See, underwriting means, in order to, I will tell you with a simple example, this word is important. You have to remember. If you go to interviews, they will ask, what do you mean by underwriting? See, suppose a company wants to establish with an initial capital of 1,000 crores. Company wants to establish with a capital of 1,000 crore rupees. See, but there is no guarantee that the company will be able to collect all 1,000 crores from the public. So that is why, as per Companies Act, as per SEBI regulation, some minimum amount of capital they should collect before starting the company. Now let us take, for example, 200 crores they have put up a target. They have set a target. 200 crores is the minimum capital that is required to start. Suppose the company is able to collect only 180 crores. remaining 20 crores are in balance, are pending. The company could not collect that 20 crores within due time. What shall the company do? Company shall be started or closed? Yes, any idea? Company has set up a target that 200 crores should be collected before 1st August. But the company collected only 180 crore rupees out of 200 minimum amount. Shall the company continue its business or shall the company be closed? What is your opinion? Yes?
Sir, it can take loans.
So including loans, everything, the company is able to collect only 180 crore rupees. Shall the company continue or shall the company close?
Continue, sir.
Very good for your response. Very good response, but the company cannot continue. As per the provisions of the Companies Act and as per the provisions of the SEBI, minimum amount of capital, it has been decided as 200 crores. Before the due date, if the company is unable to gather that amount, the company needs to return this amount to all those persons who gave them money, who gave the company this money. So 180 crores need to be returned to all the persons who gave money to the company. So it is a very tedious process. It is a very hard process. So that is why some people will give guarantee to a company for minimum subscription of capital. So these people are known as underwriters. They will give assurance. See, suppose if the minimum capital is not gathered by you, who will provide that assurance? They will give. They may be underwriters, may be bankers or financial institutions like IDBI, ICICI, IFCI, like any firm may be there, any individuals may be there, any relatives may be there. Did you understand the concept? Those persons or those institutions will provide the balance amount so that the company is not closed. Did you understand the concept?
Yes, sir.
So underwriters are those persons who give guarantee to a company for a minimum amount of capital so that the company does not suffer. So in a prospectus, it should be mentioned underwriting whether anybody is there as underwriter or not. Okay. Other statutory compliances, other requirements, whatever that are need to be taken care of as per the provisions, as per the rules and regulations will be taken care of in prospectus. I hope you understood the concept of prospectus. Did you understand? Prospectus is a document seeking money from the public by introducing itself to the public. I am doing this business. This much amount is required. I am situated here. Please provide me money. If you provide me money, with that money, I will do this. My previous history is this. Like what? Everything will be mentioned to prospective investors in a prospectus. Okay? Contents of the prospectus. What are the various contents in a prospectus? You can see. Is it clear? As per the Company Act schedule, second schedule, first part, these are the things, these are the aspects that need to be covered in prospectus of company. Is it clear? Is it visible?
Sir, visible.
The main objects of the company. What are the objectives? What are the aims? Signatories to the memorandum. In memorandum of association, persons should sign, I told. When I explained memorandum of association, I mentioned in the last, what is the last clause in memorandum of association? Subscription clause I mentioned. Those who are going to sign on memorandum of association, they should invest some money in a company I mentioned in order to protect the interests of the investors. Okay. So in prospectus, it will be mentioned who has signed in the memorandum of association. What are the main objectives of the company? Those need to be mentioned. Okay. Similarly, secondly, share capital. How much share capital the company is going to collect, that needs to be mentioned. Terms of the present issue. Means terms of the present issue means, see, the presently the company is issuing, suppose let us take for example 500 crore rupees. So regarding the issue, everything will be mentioned in a prospectus. Means with this amount, what they are going to do. Till now, what they have done with their capital. Now with this money, what they are going to do. Everything needs to be mentioned. So that is particulars of the issue. By what date we can apply for this share. See, suppose if you want to be taking an admission in a college, you will see what is the last date. Okay, how many seats are available. Whether it's a gents college, ladies college or co-education, everything you are going to see. Similarly, in prospectus also, particulars of the issue will be mentioned. What are the various issues related to this, the issue of shares. Okay, what is the value of each share? What is the last date? Everything will be mentioned. See, managerial personnel, who is acting as managing director? Who is acting as director? Who is acting as manager? Who is acting as secretary? Who is the auditor of the company? If you want to see, that needs to be there in the prospectus. Everything about managerial personnel. Okay, minimum subscription should be mentioned. I mean, suppose a company is issuing 100 rupees a share. I cannot invest 80 rupees because the company's minimum amount of minimum subscription. I mentioned in the example. See, in 1,000 crores, 200 crores, the company has to collect for starting. So that minimum subscription should be mentioned in prospectus. See, company's main total investment, how much? In that one, what is the minimum amount to be collected to begin the company needs to be mentioned. So in prospectus, minimum subscription they will mention. That needs to be there. Similarly, opening of the subscription list, when the company is going to issue, begin the subscription list, from which date we can invest, application and allotment of monies. See, how share application can be purchased, with how much money is required, how they are going to allot. Suppose 1,000 into 100 means 1 lakh rupees capital is required. The company requires 1 lakh rupees capital. Let us take for example. This 1 lakh has been divided into 1,000 parts. Means if I cancel, so each will be 100. 100 subscribers may apply for, 100 subscribers may apply for shares. See, whereas applications received are 200. Then for everybody, company cannot issue share. So in that case, how the company is going to allot shares? What is the rules? What is the rule position? What are the regulations? Those need to be mentioned in prospectus. Okay, I hope you understood. Okay, that is what you mean by saying allotment. Particulars and of options to subscribe for shares and debentures. See, debenture I mentioned, it is a loan document of a company. Shareholders are the owners. Debenture holders are the creditors of a company. They will give loan to a company. Company's loan document is known as a debenture. Whereas share means company's original investors, they are the real owners of the company. They elect the directors and the directors will run the show in the company. So whatever options that are available for shareholders, for debenture holders, they have to be mentioned in prospectus. Similarly, what are the shares and debentures issued for consideration other than cash? See, company not only requires amount in physical form, but other types of investment is also welcome. Means, suppose a person comes forward and gives the company a building. So in return, company issues a share certificate to him up to certain value. So other than cash, whatever shares are issued, whatever debentures are issued, the terms and conditions should be mentioned in prospectus. So share premium means if a company is a very good company, it is earning every year crores of rupees as profits, and every year company is paying huge dividends to shareholders. So in that case, company's 100 rupees document, 100 rupees share can be purchased only at a premium. At a premium means 100 rupees worth share, you cannot purchase for 100 rupees only. You have to purchase for 150 rupees. Because the company is in demand more, because every year they are paying huge returns to the shareholders. See, I will tell you one simple example. See, Alavaikunthapuram movie was released last year in the month of January. Let us take for example. Okay. Movie ticket cost is 100 rupees. But some idiots purchase the ticket for 200 rupees. That is purchasing for a premium. At a greater price. Similarly, if the company is enjoying more profits every year, more returns will come for the shareholders. So in that case, company's share value will increase. So if you want to invest in that company, you have to purchase a company's share for more value. 100 rupees certificate, you have to pay 150. That is premium. So what are the conditions that will be mentioned in prospectus? Similarly, underwriters. In the last 15 minutes, I discussed about underwriting. Underwriter. Who is an underwriter? What I mentioned? Who is underwriter?
They will give assurance of minimum amount of capital, sir.
Very good. Very good. They are guarantors. They give guarantee. They give minimum assurance to the company that minimum subscription is, see, minimum subscription is achieved. Minimum subscription is reached. So that if assurance is there, means the company can concentrate on its business. Otherwise, the companies will always have to think whether the minimum amount will be gathered or not, will be collected or not. Okay. So whether any underwriters are there for the company or not, you have to mention. Okay. Then preliminary expenses. See how many rupees worth preliminary expenses are over or incurred by the company. Means preliminary expenses means for the starting up of a company, some basic expenses will be there. Means preparation of a memorandum of association, preparation of articles of association, preparation of prospectus, purchasing of land, or construction of a building. Those expenses are known as preliminary expenses. Any court cases, any stamp duty, anything. Those expenses are known as preliminary expenses. Preliminary means before the starting. Okay. So those expenses, how many rupees were spent for the initial phase of a company? Then promoters, who are the promoters who are going to establish a company? Their details, their address, their qualifications will be mentioned. Details of business, what type of business they are involved in, the company is involved. Property acquired, whether land, buildings, or any other property up to now, whether they purchased anything or not, we have to mention. Restriction on articles. Whatever articles of association, whatever things that are mentioned, articles of association I mentioned, articles of association mentions the rules and regulations within which the company members have to follow. So whatever rules and regulations that are mentioned in the articles of association, any restrictions are there, any limitations are there, you have to mention. Time and place of inspection. See, if a person wants to inspect a company's affairs by looking into its profit and loss account or balance sheet or any place, the company's place they want to inspect, means what is the procedure. So material contracts, the company has to enter into contracts with other persons regarding various matters. So all those things need to be mentioned in prospectus. Only if the prospective investors are satisfied, they will invest. Otherwise, nobody will come to invest in prospectus. So that is why it is a very, very important document to attract prospective investors. This prospectus is required. Okay. So, dear students, in today's class, we have learnt about the differences between memorandum and articles of association and prospectus. So, in the next class, we will meet with another topic. Okay. Thank you very much, dear students. We will meet again.
Thank you, sir.